I'm Avinash, and that's Gaurav. We're from an audiovisual collective in New Delhi called Blot. We do performances, we make music videos, we make art, but we're here in Singapore right now to explore street food culture.
We're gonna see a guy who specializes in something called rojak, which is a very unique Singaporean idea. Seemingly, he's the fastest knife wielder on this market. That used to cut exactly like this. Rojak, it's a dish that's really special to Singapore, originating in the 1950s, and his grandfather used to run a small stall on the cycle very close to here. Hawker centers are synonymous with Singaporean food and with food culture. Depending on where you are, they tend to imbibe the food traditions of the community that surrounds them. People come here for breakfast, lunch and dinner, whether you're a businessman or a worker. There's amazing diversity, and almost all the cultures of Singapore are represented. And I got sauce on my thing. Indians eating in Singapore. There's different things which we never see in India for sure. And for me, it's fascinating, the textures, and it's really small and micro. Of course, soak in the vibe and the atmosphere here, which is really great with me. The films we make, often it's about pattern and color and many labels and,
yeah.
You know, just for us, it's really fascinating.
Yes.
A lot of what I do is stop motion on this little camera where there's repetition, bright colors and labels. It just gives this very frenetic vibe to the moving images, which represents what we're going through in Singapore quite well. So we're now at the wholesale vegetable market. It's amazing to see this kind of huge place with amazing people and a lot of activity. And also the chance to just examine vegetables up close, however geeky it sounds. I think this passion around food strikes you not only from the people who consume it, but really importantly from the people who are making it. Like the old gentleman who makes this amazing food, him and his wife, and there's queues and queues of people every day, 7 days a week. People who've spent, you know, 3-4 decades making and perfecting this dish. The creativity stopped 4 decades back when they came up with this amazing thing. And since then, it's another form of creativity, which is just determination to make it happen every day in the same way. It's some kind of a Zen meditative perfection that they're trying to seek. Amazing. Completely psychedelic. Gaurav! Psychedelic world of South Asian desserts. There's mango ice kachan and mango pudding with lychee. It's got beans in it. I mean, I don't understand why they put beans in sweets, but it's quite imaginative. Because we were reflecting on our role as performers back in India and what could we do to represent that facet of our work in Singapore while we're here.
And not get caught by the cops.
And not get caught by the cops doing something wrong. So what we've come up with is a traveling cinema. The idea is to hit some of the hawker centers and meet the people we've already met and show them what we've been doing. We wouldn't have had this amazing experience if it wasn't for the food and the people who are cooking it and the people who are eating it. Now what can we do before we go that can share that inspiration back with them?
People come from all over the world to eat at Tiong Bahru Market. It's a really good mix of Singaporeans. It's kind of like a microcosm of Singapore in a way.